soccer fields or, you know, so I think parks and recreation is about it, I think, you know, right? It does. It really does. In the woods and everything, and the parking. And we did have it sold to Byron Center, charter schools.
Oh, okay.
Not the Heisinger people, but the Byron Center charter schools. And so for them, they were looking at buying 7 acres and building a 22,000 square foot building, and it was going to cost them well over $4 million. Now this, they still had, they had 30 grand to bring cable down. You know, there is, you know, Mr. Child stripped everything. See all the, there's no air conditioning ducts in there. Right. There is electric everywhere. So one of the uses we've been talking to is a film studio out of California. And there's a local guy here. Local guy here, but the charter school, they just couldn't get the financing. They didn't get enough students. I mean, Byron Center has really good schools and really good Christian schools, so it was hard to get the student count up enough. Oh, here's Mr. Pfeiffer. Hello there, Dan. How are you? You know Jim Hart.
How are you, Jim Hart?
You betcha.
What do you think of the marble mausoleum?
What do you call it?
The Homerich Mansion.
So,
well, when do you want to move in?
Well, I got to talk to the wife.
you ought to have about 6 of them who live here.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is about 25, I believe, 25 to 28 at the peak. And so you got natural lighting all the way around. Now that Mr. Merriweather won his $300 million, we think you ought to make this an exclusive boxing campground. You know, buy this and bring boxers in from all over the world and win those gold medals. The only one he didn't win. But that's just a dream. But hey, I'm a salesman. I'm trying to sell it, right?
Yeah.
When you're going, I don't want to record on this, but it should be a brand new and be held it.
Well.
Or Parks and Recreation.
Yeah.
Charter schools, yeah, the charter schools.
Then they come up and have money. Well, Dan, how long have you held this?
2014.
Is that okay? Yeah.
About this time, 2014, he closed.
But it looks a little different now. It was so grown up and
it was just
in the summertime when the leaves are off, you couldn't imagine there's anything else around here. Mm-hmm. You know. When the leaves go off, it isn't that far to see, you know,
couple of houses.
I've about a half mile over there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So where did
Quarter mile.
So why did you buy it?
Hey, where in the world could you, I do know a little bit about building. There's a lot of money you'd spend to build it today. Mm-hmm. I think,
we're half price of just the concrete. Just the concrete.
Well, the guy supposedly spent back then before concrete.
Right.
But I mean, I spent over $3 million in it back then.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so now, you see what's happened here. It just to build it today would be, I call it a marble mausoleum.
It'd be, even in this stage right here, shelled without the air conditioning in, you're looking $100 to $150 a foot. This is 22,000 square feet. I mean, so $100 is a $21,000. Yeah. So, I mean, it's a big place. I mean, it's a $3-4 million building.
You couldn't build to that.
No, especially finish it.
Well,
if you go to finish it, it's,
well,